Preschool-aged children get sick frequently, especially during the fall and winter when common viruses circulate. While this is beneficial for training children's immune systems, these illnesses may impose externalities when spread to family members, particularly young infant siblings who are in a vulnerable stage of rapid lung and brain development. This paper quantifies these within-family externalities. Using administrative data covering all births in Denmark between 1981 and 2017, the authors track how respiratory illnesses spread from older to younger siblings during their first year of life, and how disease exposure during infancy affects younger siblings' long-term outcomes. The analysis covers first and second-born children with an age gap of at least 11 months, and comprises over 1,200,000 children. To start, this figure plots the average number of acute respiratory disease hospitalizations by child age during the first year of life. Relative to first-born children, younger siblings have 2 to 3 times higher hospitalization rates, and the difference is especially large when children are 1 and 2 months of age. Younger siblings have higher hospitalization rates regardless of season of birth, and for all children, hospitalizations are higher in the winter when common respiratory disease outbreaks are more prevalent. This means that of all subgroups, younger siblings born in the winter months have the highest hospitalization rates when they are 1 to 2 months old, indicating that this group is particularly susceptible to severe respiratory infections during early infancy. Differences in hospitalizations are also larger for siblings with shorter birth spacing, who may be more prone to the kind of close contact with one another that facilitates virus transmission. Overall, these patterns are consistent with a narrative in which older children bring home common viruses that put their younger siblings at heightened risk of severe respiratory illness in the first few months of life. What are the long-term consequences? This figure shows differences in acute respiratory disease hospitalizations during infancy by birth order and season, side by side with differences in annual earnings at age 30 across the same groups. In both cases, the groups with the highest rates of infancy hospitalizations also experience lower earnings in adulthood. But of course, these patterns are only suggestive. So to estimate the causal effect of early life respiratory disease exposure, the authors employ a quasi-experimental approach based on variation in local disease prevalence. While common respiratory viruses exhibit a strong seasonal pattern, there is still substantial variation in municipality-level disease prevalence at any given point in time. The authors capture a child's exposure to these more localized outbreaks by calculating, for each municipality, the total number of hospitalizations for acute respiratory conditions per 100 children aged 13 to 71 months. Each child is then matched to the cumulative child hospitalization rate in their municipality over their first 12 months of life. Intuitively, this captures an infant's exposure to respiratory disease from slightly older children in their local community, and the paper estimates the differential impact of this disease index on younger versus older siblings. The results show that the exposure index predicts the likelihood that a child is hospitalized for an acute respiratory illness during the first year of life, and the impact is much larger for younger than for older siblings. Moving from the 25th to the 75th percentile in the disease index distribution is associated with a 32.9% differential increase in the number of acute respiratory illness hospitalizations in the first year of life for younger relative to older children. The effects are even stronger when disease exposure is measured over the first 6 months of life, which supports the conjecture that infants are particularly vulnerable over those first months. Crucially, this early exposure has long-term consequences. For younger siblings, an interquartile increase in respiratory disease exposure during the first year of life leads to a 0.8% reduction in wages and income at ages 25 to 32, and a 0.3 percentage point reduction in the income percentile rank. These effects are again larger when disease exposure is measured over the first 6 months of life. To put these findings in context, the estimated earnings reduction associated with an interquartile increase in early respiratory disease exposure is similar to the effects of a 10% reduction in birth weight or a 9% increase in ambient air pollution in one's year of birth, and are almost two-thirds of the impact of in utero exposure to the 1918 Spanish flu pandemic. To shed light on the mechanisms behind these earnings effects, the authors study a range of other outcomes and show that exposure to severe respiratory illness during infancy leads to reductions in the likelihood of high school and college graduation and increased rates of hospitalization for chronic respiratory conditions, including asthma and COPD. Both factors may contribute to individuals' reduced earnings capacity, and there is also evidence of increases in moderate mental health conditions in young adulthood. And so, this paper provides new empirical evidence on the importance of birth order in driving susceptibility to respiratory infection. Can policy alleviate these dynamics? A supplementary analysis indicates that the short-term effects of respiratory hospitalizations in the first year of life are larger among younger siblings who are breastfed for less than 6 months, which suggests that policies that support breastfeeding, such as paid family leave and lactation spaces in workplaces, may help mitigate the negative effects of respiratory disease exposure. Vaccination campaigns are also likely to be powerful tools, especially given broader trends in misinformation and vaccine hesitancy. To read more on this topic, you can check out the paper's references to other related work. This includes research on birth order and sibling spillovers, and papers on the long-term impact of early life circumstances, including exposure to severe infectious diseases.